Hi, Robert Kurtzman from KNB Effects Group, Los Angeles.
Okay, well, what do you do for KNB?
One of the owners. It stands for Kurtzman, Nicotero, and Berger Effects Group. And my two partners aren't here. They're back in L.A.
What was the like first film you worked on?
Very first film? Like, as a company or as individual?
As an individual.
Troll.
Troll?
Yeah.
Sonny Bono, right?
Yeah, years ago. It was a bucket jockey on that one. Cleaning buckets.
Yeah.
But...
And where'd you go from there?
Well, we just finished Misery with Rob Reiner and Tales from the Dark Side, the movie. It's coming out on video. We did that. Nightmare on Elm Street films. We worked on a couple of those. And, you know, a lot of sequels.
You do any of the actual work on...
Oh, yeah. Just sculpt, design, everything. So.
What'd you do on part 5?
Halloween 5?
Yeah.
A bunch of blood gags. Resculpted the Michael Myers mask, which I had nothing to do with the nose. That was a director's choice. So, the schnoz, they call it.
The original was based on the Captain Kirk mask or something.
Yeah,
right?
Well, they didn't have it. And they just said, take it off photographs. And the director kept coming in and wanting to put sores and stuff on it. But he's a good guy, the director. But,
now, what kind of effects were cut out of Part 5 for the R rating?
Just quick, you know, gore effects. You know, arms going off, heads being cut, and...
Did you cut back on the blood for, you know, R rating?
No, Mustafa Akkad really likes to, you know, try to just work with the story and the suspense rather than the blood and the guts. So it, from the beginning, it was pretty toned down.
And who was the guy in the boots? Do you know?
What boots?
The cowboy boots with the silver tips?
You know, that got lost in the shuffle. There's this whole subplot there that just kind of gets cut out of the film. Don't really know what the hell's going on. It has to do with something like these, Aryan race type thing, you know, and how they understand why he's killing and things, or there's some supernatural connection. But
is there any parts 6 coming up?
I'm sure when they'll let it die down and then pick it up again when people aren't so sick of it. So.
And what have you done on Misery?
A lot of actors' body double stuff, like heads and. We did James Caan's broken legs. He gets his legs broken in a car accident, and then lead character, if you read the book, smashes his legs even worse, so he can't get out of the bed. Has to rewrite the novel, you know.
You did Rider Reanimator.
Rider Reanimator.
When is that due out?
November, maybe.
In the theaters.
In the theaters, November through Taurus Entertainment, and it's coming out at IVE on video. But there's copies floating around, I'm sure. No.
Did you do any of the headless man effects?
No, we did. John Buechler did that stuff. We did the bride herself, all the gags dealing with the brides, a couple reanimated corpses. And so there's a whole bunch of gags throughout the film. John Buechler, Screaming Mad George, did some stuff in the finale in the crypt. And Tony Dublin was on the film, did a couple effects. He was on the original. So it was like a crew of five-team crew, and they didn't really have a lot of time, and that's why it's a Nightmare on Elm Street syndrome. No time to build the effects, so we'll hire 20 crews to work on them rather than just one. And that's the way it worked out, but it worked out real well. It's going to be a good film.
Any problems with effects, you think? Has it got a rating yet?
It got an R rating, and they cut very little from the director's cut. The humor really saves it, because it's so funny. You just can't take the blood and guts seriously, you know? You had to kind of just enjoy it. Kind of like Basket Case and Frankenhooker, you know.
You've done that work on that?
No, but it's the same
like
film.
Vein.
Yeah, it's a cult type audience, and the humor. It's good.
What are you working on next?
We're doing 3 films with Fangoria Magazine right now. We're on the 3rd one. It's called Army. And we just finished Tony Randall, working with Tony Randall, who directed Hellraiser 2.
He did Hellraiser 2?
Right. And he directed this one. It's a vampire tale. With some new twists, some pretty cool effects, I think. You know, we tried to change the theme of the vampires, and not the stereotypical guy with a widow's peak and a fangs running around with a cape. There's a little bit of that in there, but some new vampire twists with the legend. The 3rd one, Army, is about a bunch of arms that run around and kill people.
Arms?
They detach off guys and run around and kill them and stuff. And they have tails. And, what else? that's it right now. Finishing that up, and we've got Dancing with Wolves and Misery coming out this fall, so it'll be fun.
Okay.
I got slides in the slideshow tomorrow, but you'll be able to see all the stuff.
Okay. Okay, thanks a lot.
Yeah.